Good morning, students. In today's lecture, we will discuss some important theorems related to semi-simple modules. So our first theorem today is, let M be an R module. Then we will prove that the following conditions are equivalent. First condition, M is semi-simple. Semi-simple means completely reducible. Second condition, M is the direct sum of simple submodules. And the third condition is, every submodule of M is direct summand of M. So first of all, we proved that 1 implies 2. In order to prove 1 implies 2 and 2 implies 3, we will use the theorem which we discussed yesterday. Now here, because M is semi-simple module, so we can use that theorem. So according to that theorem, if M is semi-simple and N is some module of M, then there exists a subfamily of the given family of indexes. Given family of indexes we have denoted by uppercase lambda. And its subfamily we have denoted by taking this prime on the power. This is a subfamily of this family of indexes, such that M can be written as N direct sum summation M lambda, where lambda belongs to this subfamily. Now here, if we take N as the zero module, then from here we get M is equal to direct sum summation M lambda, where lambda belongs to the existing subfamily of indexes. And by definition, we have proved that M is the direct sum of simple submodules. So this completes condition 1 implies condition 2. Now, in the next part, we will prove condition 2 implies condition 3. In the condition 2, we are given that M is the direct sum of simple submodules. And we are to prove that N is direct summand of M. Now, because N is submodule of M and M is summation M lambda, where lambda belongs to the family of indexes. So again, we can use that same theorem. So by that theorem, there will exist a subfamily of given family of indexes. That subfamily we have denoted by uppercase lambda with double prime sign in the power, such that M can be written as N direct sum summation M lambda, where lambda belongs to the existing subfamily of indexes. Now, according to the requirement, let us denote this direct sum as N dash. Then N dash is also a sum module of M. And this expression becomes M is equal to N direct sum N dash. So we have proved that for N sum module of M, there exists another sum module N dash of M, such that M can be written as N direct sum N dash. So by definition, we can see that N is the direct summand of M. So this completes second implies third. Now, in the last part, we will prove that condition 3 implies the condition 1. In the condition 3, we are given that every submodule of M is direct summand of M. And we are to prove that M is semi-simple. Now, to prove that M is semi-simple, first of all, we prove that M has simple submodules. So let us take a non-zero element X belonging to M, and let us take N generated by X. Now, because N is finitely generated, and every finitely generated R module has a maximum sum module by John's lemma, so we can take a maximal submodule of n. So let us take n be the maximal submodule of n. Now n is submodule of m, l is submodule of n, and n is submodule of m. So we can say l is submodule of m. Now we are given in the statement that every submodule of m is direct summand of m. So we can say that l is direct summand of m. So we can apply the definition of direct summand. So by definition, there will exist a submodule, say l dash of m, such that m can be written as the direct sum of l and l dash. Now, because n is submodule of m, so n is contained in m, and m is the direct sum of l and l dash. So if we take any arbitrary element from n, that will belong to the sum of l and l dash. So let us take z belonging to n, then z will also belong to the sum of l and l dash. So by definition of linear sum, z will be of the form of sum of the elements taken from l and l dash. So let us take one element l from the submodule l and l dash from the submodule l dash. So z becomes l plus l dash. From here, z minus l, that will be l dash. Now this z, that belongs to the submodule n. L belongs to l, but l is also contained in n. So l will also belong to n. Now z belongs to n, l belongs to n, n is a submodule of m. So z minus l also belongs to n. L dash belongs to l dash. And because z minus l is equal to l dash, so we can see that this element belongs to the intersection of n and l dash. Z minus l belongs to n intersection l dash. And because l belongs to l, so z belongs to the sum of the submodules l and n intersection l dash. This is arbitrary element taken from n, and that is belonging to the sum of these two submodules of m. So we can say that n is contained in the sum of the submodules l and n intersection l dash. And now this is further contained in n. So we can say that n is the linear sum of the submodules l and n intersection l dash. Now, we have to show that this sum is the direct sum. For this, we require the intersection of L with this submodule, that should be 0. So let us find the intersection of L with N intersection L dash. Now this intersection, that is further contained in L intersection L dash. And we have already proved M is equal to L direct sum L dash. Intersection of L with L dash, that is 0 module. So this intersection is 0 module. So we have proved L intersection N intersection L dash, that is 0. Now let us consider the factor module N by L, substituting the value of N. Now we can use the second theorem of homomorphism of modules. So according to that theorem, this factor module will be isomorphic to n intersection l dash upon l intersection n intersection l dash. Now this intersection we have proved as 0. So n by l is isomorphic to n intersection l dash. Now because l is maximal submodule of n, so n by l, that will be simple R module. And because this is simple, so this module N intersection L dash being isomorphic to simple R module, so this will also be simple R module. So we have proved that N intersection L dash is simple R submodule of M. So here we have proved that M has simple submodules. Now let us turn towards our main result. We are to prove that M is semi-simple. It means we are to show that M is the sum of simple submodules. Now because M has simple submodules, so let us consider a collection of all the simple submodules of M, and that collection we have denoted by tau, and the sum of the members from this collection we denote by x. Now we are to prove that M is equal to x. Now because x is the sum of submodules of M, and sum of submodules of M is again a submodule of M, so we can say that x is submodule of M. And by given condition, every submodule of M is direct summand of M, so we can say that x is direct summand of M. So by definition of direct summand, there will exist another submodule of M, say x dash, such that M can be written as the direct sum of x and x dash. Now if we are able to prove that x dash is zero module, then M will be same as x and our result will be proved. So in order to prove that x dash is zero module, we will prove it by contradiction. Let if possible this x dash is not equal to zero module. As in the first step, we can show that x dash will have simple submodules. Let us take one of the simple submodule is denoted by P. Then P will belong to the collection tau, and also P being to collection tau, that will implies that P is contained in X. X is summation M lambda. Also P is contained in X dash because P is a submodule of X dash. Now P is contained in X, P is contained in X dash, so P will be contained in their intersection also. But from here we can see that the sum of X and X dash, that is a direct sum, so their intersection, that will be zero. So P is contained in zero module, so we get P is equal to zero module. But this is a contradiction because P is simple, and by definition of simple submodule, P cannot be zero module. So this contradiction proves that this assumption is wrong. It means x dash should be zero module. So we get M is equal to x, and x is summation M lambda. So we have proved M is the sum of simple submodules. So this proves that M is semi-simple. Now next important theorem based on semi-simple modules. In this theorem we will prove that sum module and factor module of semi-simple module is again semi-simple. So let us take M be a module which is semi-simple. Semi-simple means completely reducible. So M is completely reducible R module. We claim that every sum module and quotient module is completely reducible R module. Now to prove this, first of all let us take M is semi-simple R module and N be any submodule of M. We are to prove that N is semi-simple R module. To prove N is semi-simple R module, we will prove that every submodule of N is direct summand of N. So let us take an arbitrary submodule of N. So let us take A be any submodule of N. Now because N is submodule of M, so A is submodule of N and N is submodule of M implies that A is submodule of M. Now because M is semi-simple, so by definition of semi-simple, every submodule of M is direct summand of M. So by definition, A is direct cement of M. So by definition of direct cement, there will exist a sum module, say M A dash of M, such that M can be written as A direct sum A dash. Now, let us take an arbitrary element X belonging to N. Now, because N is sum module of M, so X will also be element of M. Now, M is the direct sum of A and A dash. So, the elements of M will be of the form of sum of elements of A and A dash. So, X can be written as A plus A dash, where A belongs to A and A dash belongs to A dash. From here, we can find the value of A dash, which is given by X minus A. Now, because X is element of N, A is element of A, but A is containing N. So A will also be element of N. A belongs to N, X belongs to N. So X minus A belongs to N. Now, because X minus A is equal to A dash, so we can say that X minus A belongs to N intersection A dash. So from here, we can say that X belongs to A plus N intersection A dash. Now this is containing N. So we have proved that N is the sum of the sum modules A and N intersection A dash. Now, we have to prove that this sum is direct sum. So let us find the intersection of A with N intersection A dash. Now, because this intersection is contained in A intersection A dash, and we have already proved M is A direct sum A dash. So intersection of A with A dash is zero module. So we have proved intersection of A with N intersection A dash, that is zero. So this sum will become the direct sum. So N is the direct sum of A and N intersection A dash. And by definition, we have proved that A is direct summand of N. A is an arbitrary sum module of N. So we can say that every sum module of N is direct summand of N. So by definition, this proves that N is semi-simple R module. So this completes our first part, that sum module of semi-simple R module is again semi-simple. Now in the next part, we'll prove that quotient module of semi-simple R module is again semi-simple. So let us consider the factor module M by N. Here N is sum module of M. We have to prove that M by N is completely reducible. Now to prove this, now here N is sum module of M and M is semi-simple. So by definition, every sum module of M is direct summand of M. So N is direct summand of M. So by definition of direct summand, there will exist a sum module, say N dash of M, such that M can be written as N direct sum N dash. Now let us consider the factor module M by N and substituting the value of M. And M is the sum of N and N dash. Now we can use the second theorem of homomorphism of modules. So according to that theorem, this factor module will be isomorphic to the factor module N dash by N intersection N dash. Now N intersection N dash, that is zero module. So this will be isomorphic to N dash. Now N dash is the sum module of completely reducible module. And sum module of completely reducible module is again completely reducible. So N dash is completely reducible. And the factor module M by N, that is isomorphic to N dash. And so we can say that m by n is also completely reducible. So this proves that quotient module of semi-simple module is again semi-simple. So this completes the proof of this theorem.